Hey everyone, this is LuckySevenDX, and welcome back to Let's Play Kirby Squeak Squad. In the last episode, we completed World 2 and used Ninja Kirby to beat up Mole. And we're gonna just quickly change this copy palette because I forgot to show this last time, and I'll show off the boss badge as well because that's really cool. But what I'm actually doing right here is I'm back here with Wheel Kirby so I can show off Wheel Kirby's special ability because I haven't really got a chance to do that yet. So what you need to do is you need to bring over here to one of the little fire on the ground things, one of those things right there. And I have trouble getting up there for some reason because I suck at Wheel Kirby, but that's okay. So we get up there and, yeah. So wheel plus fire equals that flaming wheel thing. And oh my god, I am on fire. That's right, you can do that. As you can see, we're gonna burn right through these bushes and just generally burn anything that gets in our way, which is, I mean, it's an interesting gimmick. We actually get the meat there, that's pretty cool. But yeah, it's an interesting gimmick. What you also can do, though, with that is you can use snow or there's little spark things in the ground to also get an ice or spark attribute to your wheel. It's a gimmick. You don't really use it that much, but I guess it's better than nothing. I mean, wheel is wheel. You can't really do much to add on to that, I feel. That's kind of the case for a lot of the ability scrolls, though. There's some abilities you just really can't add much to. But anyway, one of the ones you can, but we don't unfortunately have yet, is Ninja, and I love Ninja. Seriously, they improved Ninja so much more over the Kirby Superstar version, I feel. The Ninja in this game, and I just freaking get eaten there. Oops! Kirby almost looks like one of those things when he's this color, which is kind of weird. I love the dropkick move he has now. I don't know, it's just generally better, I feel, than the one in Superstar just didn't do much damage, plus you don't get the cool shuriken, I feel. I mean, shuriken just make everything better. This is fact. But yeah, 3-1, we're in Cushy Cloud, which is a cool name for a level, I suppose. Cushy. This is Cushy Cloud. It's so cushy. Yep, good times. Man, it's been forever since I've recorded this episode like a long time ago, so it's been a long time since I actually played this. It's kind of interesting seeing it now. Yeah, finals and puzzle, just people have been around all the time, I just haven't had a chance to record, which sucks. I'm hoping I can get back into a better schedule soon, but we'll see. And you can grab the meat there before this guy gets out of the way. That's cool. Alright, enough talking about Ninja. Let's go ahead and get Spark. Spark seems like a good time. Yay for Spark. I don't think we've used Spark in a while. Since I actually have nothing down there right now, we're not going to use Spark much, though, because there's actually a new ability here. It's Laser. Man, if you guys remember from late, Amazing Mirror, I used to hate Laser, but now I just love it. It is a pretty good long-range ability, plus all the reflections you can get with it. Pretty cool. So, Laser, you're pretty legit. I'm gonna pause and show off right here. Optical Weapon Armed! It's rumored to be a bigger beam than it used to be. Oh, just wait till we get the ability scroll. I love the ability scroll for this one. Yeah, so we're just gonna shoot up here and be able to fly up here, and we'll eventually run to a treasure chest. But anyway, as I mentioned, the bomb screen cleared out, our lives are reset. That means that pretty much I had a new recording session, so I just started from the beginning, I guess. You know, no save states, none of that crap. We're just gonna start fresh. And yeah, when you do that, the lives do reset, and you lose all the items down there. But, you know, no big deal. You never really need anything down there. Generally, the levels almost always give you what you need to complete them within the level somewhere. Sometimes you have to actually go your way to find it, like right here. Because we're gonna go up here, in the secret one over here. And we're going to find a throw bubble. And we're gonna actually need a throw in a second to get the other little treasure chest. So yeah, they always do include what you need, though. Generally, you get the rare abilities, too, though, which is kinda cool. Throw is pretty rare. I think it's even the first time you've seen a throw bubble, period. But yeah, so we're gonna switch to throw, and we're gonna whip the star at everything, because that's what we do. We just throw stuff and win throw. Yeah, you need to get through those gray blocks. Like I mentioned before, I think in the last video, hammer can go through it, burning can, well, fire in this game. But throw also can, so throw is the way this level wants to you to do it, I think. Anyway, this Squeaker's trying to make up the big treasures, and we can't allow that, so we're gonna pick him up, and we are going to whip him at his master of their spinny. Get over here, you stupid ninja, and I missed. But we're not gonna let him get away with that. Take this! Eat mouse. Mouse? That makes no sense. Oh, spinny. You're just so much fun to beat up. Really, that's half the fun of this game, is just beating up the Squeakers, and I accidentally go in here, which is really, really dumb. But, you know, that's okay. It's always fun to fight these things. Except for the, I don't know, they really are annoying with all their bombs, though. You really have to be careful fighting these things, and I luckily hit that bomb in midair. Especially those blue ones. Those blue ones could be a huge pain. I just throw him right into his own bomb. Just like, yo, don't throw bombs at me. Eat your own bomb, buddy. And the Squeaker, some reason he's giving me trouble. At least my throw ability. Spinny's trying to make it, but Spinny gets a start of the face, and we're just gonna bleed this level. 3-1's complete. Good job. Good job, son. Alright. I don't know why I just said that. And what are we gonna get? What are we gonna get? I'm so excited. do your Kirby dance. Hurry up, open it. We're gonna get, a new spray paint, and we're gonna get the Spark Scroll. Spark Scroll's actually pretty cool, I have to admit. I like the Spark Scroll. It does add even more onto the new revamped Spark. But anyway, we're gonna have Grape Kirby, because, you know, who doesn't love the color purple? Yep, here's a good list of all the, I think we've shown off all these except the Spark Scroll, because we just got that, so... You know, we're getting there on the treasures. We're making a good dent into things now. But we're gonna grab ice, because ice is kind of handy here. You can freeze the water, and that doesn't really accomplish much, I guess. But I think this is the first true like water based level, I guess. I don't know why there's a water level in a cloud world. Who knows? But speaking of which, cloud world, take a guess who the boss is. But well, you'll see, guys. Interesting stuff. Now, the thing about Sword, one of the other reasons why it's such an awesome ability, is it's one of the few abilities you can use underwater, which is why you should actually grab it, because you need it right now to hit this block over here. Yeah, it gives you a nice bit of range underwater, more than your little water-blowing thing works, although I suppose just blowing water out of your mouth enemies is just kind of gross, so... I don't know, pick your poison, I guess. Either way, the enemies are gonna be feeling the pain, I suppose. I don't know. Would blowing water at like a fish underwater really be that painful? And I almost lose my sword ability here, but that's unacceptable. We're gonna dive back in and grab that. I'm not gonna get wet. I'm just gonna be like, nope. I have good sucking power. Ooh, but here we go. We haven't shown Beam yet, have we? Well, first I'll show off Spark, because I don't want to fight this upcoming boss with Spark. As you can see, we can now tap it more. We can charge more. You actually get two abilities with the Spark one, which is pretty cool. You can now expand this even further to get a barrier like this. You can use the barrier to a bigger blast, like that, or you can also fire it off like that. It's like a projectile, which is kind of cool. However, the projectile takes so long to charge up, and it's so finicky that generally it's not good to use as a projectile. Generally, the most useful thing about the Spark ability really is just that little barrier there, because it is really handy to have that like sort of plasma barrier surrounding you. Anyway, we're gonna fight Boxy. He returns from Amazing Mirror, and you know what that means. You know what ability we're about to get. Oh, I am so excited. But here we go. Here's the new beam, by the way. It's just I'm not sure if it's a faster whip or just a stronger whip, but it basically just enhances beam. I mean, why not? Beam's a cool ability. It's always nice to have it better. Boxy is just destroying me, though, which is not cool, so I'm gonna grab it, and here we go. Magic. Now, they drastically changed magic from Amazing Mirror. Now, as you can see, you have a variety of really awesome moves, and a fourth one we haven't seen yet, but the three we get are really cool. So you can do this, which is like a triple directional attack. You can get a really fast, long-ranged card attack, or you get this clown thing, which just wrecks anything above you. Generally, magic is just an amazing ability. Really rare to get, but honestly, one of my favorite abilities in this game. It just is really... It's sort of an all-around useful ability to have, so... I'm definitely gonna be using it when I can. And it's just cool to throw birds and cards at your opponent, especially the clowns. It's like, peekaboo, clown attack. I hate clowns. But yeah, great ability. I love it so much. Plus, I mean, you just look really badass with that hat. I mean, come on, how can you hate it? And the clown just wrecks everything. The clown's especially good against some certain bosses, which just... anything above you, the clown. The jack-in-the-box clown. This is a beautiful thing. And this Doc here is gonna get a bunch of cards to the face, and then he's going to go drown in the pond there. Oh, and he calls another UFO. Flee! Oh wait, nope. Oh, Jack in the Box! Oh, he's almost dead. That Jack in the Box, look how quickly that Jack in the Box just kills anything in the air like that. Such a strong move, I love it. And we're gonna get the tomato. And we're gonna complete 3-2. Making good progress. Alright, what do we got in here? We got some notes and a star seal. Like I said, those will be coming to play in a few worlds from now. Level 3-3, nothing else to talk about, really. Alright, let's see what we got in store for us this time. Got a Cutter bubble, no one really cares. Cutter, you know my opinion on Cutter. We do have Tornado, though. As much as I love magic, we may as well do what the level wants and use Tornado. Because I know we're gonna see some other cool stuff in a little bit anyway. And I guess this is really... I mean, Tornado is a much more useful ability now that can go through blocks, so... It generally is not that bad. You don't really get to use it that much in this level. Now here's actually a pretty interesting segment. Here it actually uses Parasol in a pretty interesting way, because you're supposed to use it and then fly up to protect yourself from the falling bomb things here, because as you can see, they can't handle touching the Parasol. Even though they can supposedly explode, you would think an umbrella would not be good enough to protect from explosions, but apparently it is. So, what's up with that? I don't know. I have a poke, and it's dead. We just killed an angel using an umbrella. Excellent. There's not really much in here, though, except for a bubble up. bubble, which is kind of surprising. If you fly over here, though, you can actually grab one of these bomb guys, which I'm going to do because bomb is an all-around awesome ability. I do love bomb. I think in terms of long-range, longer-range abilities, bomb is probably the best, and especially for certain bosses and the boss attack that we're going to be doing at some point, bomb is definitely the, I guess, move of choice. Now, unfortunately, we do need a cutter here if you want to be cutting these ropes and getting things, which I guess you don't need to do, but I can show off. I guess cutter, the only way it would really be useful as a long-range attack would be if you jump over the returning blade, the boomerang, I guess. I don't know. Cutter, whatever, but you can use cutter here to cut the ropes and trap the emo wild D. Ooh, so make sure you don't hit him over the edge there, because cutter won't kill him in one hit, as you can see. But yeah, make sure you hit those things so he doesn't go and commit suicide in the pit, because then you'll lose a treasure chest. Oh, golden wildies, they're probably one of the more awesome parts of this level, and I almost lost that bottle, which I don't really even need. Why do I have one of those little Kirby things? I don't know right now. It's kind of annoying. Anyway, we're gonna kill some chips, because they're annoying. We're gonna kill these little green blob things, too. I don't know if I've explained that yet, but those green blobs, if you... We're gonna get bomb back, by the way. If you try to suck up those green blob things, they will actually hurt you, so make sure you kill them with an ability, or your slide tackle, or your little puffy blow breath thingy that you do when you puff up, and that was just a poor explanation. But anyway, use a bomb there, because it'll give you enough time to get up there and get to the gate, and then... This guy is going to want to stop us, but who cares, we have bomb, and we are just going to wreck the living crap out of him. Just, he has no chance against our bomb flurry. This is why I love bomb. It just, everything, I mean, even has the fire attribute, and, I guess, like all the different attributes, like fire and spark and ice, it affects the Squeaks the same way it does Kirby, as it stuns them a lot more than usual, so... That alone also makes bomb really, really useful, because you can really stun Storo or Spinny or whoever. I love knowing their names. They're really fun to say. Storo, Spinny. Alright, what do we have? We have the map and the ghost medal once again. Ooh, secrets. Alright, 3-4. Let's continue on. Hey, it's Bubble. Bubble, also love that. So, we're gonna... Actually, is this where I... Do I show Mixing Up the Stars? I think I do here. Which I kind of did last time because I got it in a question mark thing, but I'm also gonna go back and grab another bubble, because you never know when you need a bubble. Always a useful ability to store down there when you, just in case you ever need it, because it is the only ability that lets you store other abilities, if that makes any sense. Yeah, so you can combine two stars to make a bigger star. You can actually do it one more time to make a really, really big star, as I'm gonna show here. And look at that giant, super big star here. You can only go up to 3, though, I think. And look at that giant star. That thing does a lot of damage to anything it hits, so... You know, it's not bad to have one of those things stored down there, but in general, I just prefer to store abilities down there. Plus, you really need the space for treasure chests anyway, so... Whatever, at this point, I should've probably just made a fire bubble, but... Who cares? The cannon mechanic is back. If you use some sort of fire ability, you can burn the rope, and then it'll launch the cannon. And you'll end up in a secret area. Now these clouds, the thing about these clouds is you can only get through them using a fire type move, which generally would be fire. So you have to use fire, and for some reason I totally failed to get the fire back here because I'm stupid. Yes, Kirby, look down in shame. But yeah, so clouds, you can burn through them with fire. I'm not sure the logic behind that. I don't think clouds can set on fire, but... We'll just go with that. I'm not gonna get metal here. No way in hell am I gonna sit there and fly up this thing with metal. Just go away, metal. Go away. Get out of here. If you head down here, let's see a question mark thing, which is, I suppose, kinda useful to see what we can get here. This metal thing is trying to get out of our way. We're gonna spit a star. It kills in one hit, actually. Yeah, that just shows how strong those stars are, because you know those metal things, they take a little bit, they take quite a bit of damage, actually. A surprising amount of damage. Eh, get some useless bubbles here. Nothing big. And we actually got a tomato from that, question mark thing, which I guess is fine. I don't know, you don't really get too much useful here. Now, you're gonna want to get a fire here, because as you can see, there are clouds all around, and you can burn through those pretty nicely and get some cool stuff, which, you know, that's always what we want to do. So if you actually head all the way over here, though, through this thing, we will find yet another new ability in a bubble. UFO Kirby. Now, this is what I was talking about earlier when I said that laser... There's something like really, really good that turns projectiles, and yeah, UFO is probably the king of like long-range combat, I suppose, which we'll actually be seeing in a future video. But yeah, UFO Kirby, I don't think I'm gonna show it right now. You know, it's gonna be a bit, but I will show it in this episode. It's just an awesome ability. It's probably one of the rarest of the abilities, but it is pretty good, so definitely love to have that in store when I can. Okay, here you do not want to blow up that bomb block there. That will actually screw you out of getting the treasure. So what you want to do is you want to go all the way around here and do it go from the other side here. So it's kind of like a trap there. So you burn that, and then use your fire to burn the bomb block from underneath, and how the freaking hell did I miss that? Did you see that? Did you see what I just saw? Did you see that? I mean, how? How do you miss something like that? I don't know. I, like, missed to the right, and I swooped back to the left, and I missed to the left, but who cares? Right now, I have to race Spinny. Having fire here is very useful, because there will be a point where we have to burn through the clouds, and I totally miss the switch, is good. But, you know, he takes his sweet time, as long as you have fire to really speed you up there. And generally, it doesn't even matter. Actually, fire in general is just useful because, I mean, the burning does speed you up in the end, so... I mean, you can generally get ahead of him pretty easily. So, yeah, just burning through all the clouds makes it a lot easier. And then you can just start cut him off here, get him out of the way of your fire. I don't have room right now, so I'm actually going to use UFO, I think, right here. Indeed, it's UFO Kirby! The sexy purple thing. Wow, so, like, you didn't really copy UFO, you actually got a bubble Kirby, but, you know, that's cool. As you can see, we have, you can basically store power by holding MB. You can either do a beam attack, a thing similar to the laser Kirby, a bigger laser, or a really, really, really big laser, and boom, that thing does a lot of damage. You can see, Spinny's already almost dead, so we're actually gonna finish him off right here. I'm gonna charge up my laser, and boom! Spinny's dead. Spinny's dead! And also, as you can see, UFO, you don't need to really float around. You kind of can... You have a bit more maneuverability in the air, and you're pretty fast, unlike Cupid Kirby, which makes UFO also pretty useful. Plus, as you're going to show in a bit, because I'm actually going to have to cut to, you know, go get that other treasure I missed. How the hell did I miss that? I don't know. Oh, by the way, new color, Lavender Kirby. Hell yeah. But yeah, there's also one other funny thing of UFO I'm going to show off in just a second. But first, we need some Lavender. Yes. How that's really that much different from Grape, I don't know. They look pretty much the same. Even the UFO looks, well, I guess it's slightly different. Anyway, here we go, I'm gonna show up this thing of UFO. So if you use a bubble with this, oh my god, fat top heavy UFO. You actually can't move when you have a bubble in your mouth. So don't try doing that, but it looks really funny. Anyway, try number two for this. Come on, can we do it? Can we do it? Can we not be retarded this time? Of course we can do it, come on, that's so easy. I don't know how I missed it the first time. Hello, fail montage for that. Anyway. What do we get in this treasure? Who knows? Just get the big one just for the hell of it. Because it's fun beating up Spinny. I don't want Spinny to grab my treasure chests, even if they're grayed out. But we get the high jump scroll. This is going to be really useful. But for that, this is LuckySevenDX signing out. I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.